You saved us out there yesterday.
Yeah. I thought about what I could have done instead, but I was not going to let one of Galanax's minions destroy you guys.
It's a good thing that you showed up at the time you did. So, why did you want to meet me here?
I want to tell you how I became a Power Ranger and what my life was like when I had to live with Jason for a while.
Okay, can you tell me what your life was like when you had to live with Jason for a while first?
I guess so. When I was 4 years old, my family decided that I should live with Jason for a while. What I didn't know back then was that Jason's father drinks alcohol, but not so much to be an alcoholic. I would often ask his father to put the bottle down. The first day I was there, I was in Jason's bedroom and my back was to the door. All I could hear was the family war. 2 years later, I was living with my family when I found that Jason Lee Scott died. For 3 years, I've been trying to carry on the legacy that he left for me.
Okay, so how did you become a Power Ranger?
I was walking around town one day when I got attacked by some play patrollers, and I somehow got captured by Lord Zedd and Rita Repulsa. They gave me a Power Coin under one condition.
What was the condition?
The condition was that they would not put a spell on me to make me evil. Anyway, I was teleported to the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers headquarters, and that's when Jason Lee Scott gave me a Mighty Morphin Power Rangers morpher.
Father, I'd love to leave you alone, but I can't leave you alone.
I told Joe my story about how I became a Power Ranger and what my life was like when I had to live with Jason for a while.
Well, can you tell me both stories?
Yeah. Hey, I just remembered that one day when I was talking to Tommy Oliver, he said that Kimberly got together with Jason, and I asked Jason Lee Scott if that was true, and he said that it was.
That's so messed up. Why would she cheat on him with his best friend?
I don't know. I remember the phone call between them after Jason died. I think it all started when Tanya cheated on her with Catherine.
More than you could ever love me. So go and tell your friends that I'm obsessive and crazy. That's why you won't fight if I stay. By the way, I hate that stupid old pickup truck and never let me drive. You're a redneck heartbreak who's really bad at lying. Watch me strike out mad on all my wasted time. As far as I'm concerned, you're just another picture to burn. There's no time for tears, I'm just sitting here planning my revenge. Here planning my revenge. There's nothing stopping me from going out with all of your best friends. And if you come around saying sorry, just another picture to burn.